I am here to share my thoughts and share my journey. So let's begin. So I am Rahul Pawar. Basically, I am from Satara district and my hometown is Karad. So things apart, so my childhood was into Karad only and I was into Marathi medium school. So are you all comfortable with English plus Marathi? Yes, then it's okay. So I did my schooling from Karad only. After that, during my SSC period, I was into sports also. So for matlab jab hum bolte hai na ki apni zindagi mein sabse zyada achieve kya kiya hai, so whenever it comes to me, the thing that I have achieved most in my life is that I was the national player and I was the captain of Maharashtra for the netball game and tug of war game. I was into both games and I played nationals and various state level games. So I was bit type of all rounder, and if we consider academics during my school days, so I was among the toppers in my school days. I got 94% and it got added 25% of sports, and so my total was 98%. So after schooling, during my schooling period, my elder brother, who is currently BE mechanical also, so he was then studying into a government polytechnic Karad. So from 8th standard, my approach was to do engineering because all of my brothers and my cousins, they are into mechanical engineering field. So basically due to that thing, I decided to go for mechanical engineering. I'm not like that I forced my family to come into this field. So I decided to go with engineering and particularly mechanical engineering. So whenever after 10th result, there comes to decision to choose whether 11th, 12th or diploma. How many guys are from your diploma? Nobody. Okay. So I decided diploma because first thing, my city has government diploma college which was near to me, so that was first criteria. Second thing, my brother was studying into that college, so I took the admission over there. I completed my diploma. So during last year of diploma, I got placed into three companies. First was Bajaj Automobile, second was Thermax Ltd which is leading boiler manufacturer, and third was L&T. Then due to my personal experiences, I went with Thermax. So I was into Thermax for 1 year. So talking about diploma, I elected as a general secretary in my diploma of government polytechnic Karad. In third year I was GS, in second year I was the major game secretary. So politics was much comfortable with me. So apart from the politics, I was involved into many CSR activities. CSR activities means like social responsibilities. So during my tenure as GS, we have organized many blood donation camps, tree plantation camps like that. And also I am the member of RSP, that is Road Safety Patrol, which works for the road accidents and all. So we aware the peoples about the road accidents and traffic rules to be followed like that. So I was into that field also. And after that diploma, I joined the Thermax, and traveling is my one more hobby. And main thing happened what, ki into Thermax I got the department which had traveling exposure. So I was into technical services. Generally what I wanted to do is to meet the clients, to resolve their queries and to send report back to the R&D department. So like that I was into technical services department, so I got more exposure to the clients and the various states. So that was also part of my hobby. So during my period in Thermax, I got award, excellent employee award during my tenure into Thermax. And after that I decided to switch the job and let's continue with the engineering, because I joined the Thermax just to take experience, because I knew that let's take example of my cousins or friends, that they have doing engineering but yet they didn't get the job. So what I thought, that if I do the job right now in Thermax, Thermax is a reputed company, then it will be easier to get me job after completing degree, because I wasn't sure that I will get admission into COEP or VJT or any reputed institute so that I can grab the job very easily. So I wasn't that much sure, that's why I joined the Thermax company to secure my future, part of future, not future. So I went with Thermax, then after 1 year I switch and took admission to RSCOE, like cap admission. I didn't get any premium college more than JSPM, so I took admission there. Then during my engineering period, I decided not to go with any politics in this college, because I wanted to focus on my career. You are mechanical engineers, you are most aware about MPSC, UPSC. So MPSC, in MPSC there is a one post called Assistant Motor Vehicle Inspector, which comes under RTO department, and they recruit mechanical engineers only through the exams, MPSC exams. So particularly mechanical engineer can give that exam, and I gave that exam on diploma basis, and I got selected into RTO also. But due to some court issues, that exam is still pending into the court. So after that, that exam was into second year. In third year I gave the RRB exam, I passed the RRB's pre-exam, and just in last month I gave its mains exam. So mains results are yet to be pending, and right now into BE I am giving the RRB's second JEE exam. So this was about my other than mechanical engineering approaches. So this was my entire journey till now. So in BE what happened, I got placed into four companies, as he told you earlier, that is Bajaj Finserv. I did internship there, so I got pre-placement opportunity. One is Pinclick Ltd, which is Bangalore based company in sales and marketing. Then third one company is Lab&life Instruments, which is a manufacturer of evaporators, incubators, which is based in Mumbai. And recently, just 15 days ago, I got placed into Kirloskar Chillers, which is through ISRE membership. So ISRE is, you know about Indian Society for Heating, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning, which is just like your TRS, the Robotics Society. The Robotics Society is restricted to mechatronics field. Like that, ISRE is restricted to thermal field or HVAC industries. So I was member of that. So right now I am placed into the that Kirloskar Chillers through that exam. So right now I can't say that I have achieved my whole dream. My dreams are to be coming soon, and I'm working on that. So I will not stop on Kirloskar Chillers like that, because my dream is to become a government officer, maybe technical or non-technical, whatever may be. If I got technical opportunity like RTO or RRB junior engineer, I will grab that opportunity. Otherwise, if it comes to non-technical opportunity, I will also grab that opportunity. So my main motive is to become a reputed government officer. That's it. And so this was about for my. Now I would like to tell you something about the mechanical engineering opportunities in future. So first of all, how many of you want to do startups? Yes, that one. So for startup, doing startup, you must know that IITs has various incubation centers for the startup. So you just have to put ideas in front of them and they will assist you. So that is one point. Second thing for engineering, first of all, let me tell you that for core engineering, there is a recession is going on. So there is very tough to get job into core industries. For getting that job, you must have sound knowledge rather than your marks, because I know my pointer is 9, but I'm not among the toppers of department. I'm not the topper. I just have 9 pointer. My rank will be 5 to 10 or whatever. But still, toppers may not get opportunity, and the person who has average marks will get that opportunity on the basis of what? Knowledge only. So don't study marks oriented, study only knowledge oriented. In last year, you will get more options, as he is a TPC coordinator. He is much more aware about that. Our college placement has list of companies like IT, IT enabled services, sales and marketing, and core. So these are the four major sectors for placement. So if you talk about the IT, then IT you have options of Tech Mahindra, Infosys, Wipro, TCS, like that. If you want to make career into that industry, then you are must aware about the programming languages. So you must start with the C and C++. If you are not aware about it, that is must. I have decided into my third year that I won't go to that field, so I didn't do anything about that. I didn't even appear for the any IT company or ITS company. Whenever it comes to sales and marketing, I appeared, that is Pinclick company, which is a sales and marketing company. I appeared for that because my next motto is I'm going to do MBA next year. I'm not going to opt for MTech and all. My interest is into MBA, so I'm going to opt for MBA. That's why I appeared for the Pinclick and I got selected. So third option is a core. So core, whenever it comes to core, no company has visited to our campus. So it's very difficult to get opportunity through our college to get into any core industry. We hope that company will arrive, that higher company visited just, but they had very less package. So that kind of confusions were there. So you just have to firm that where you want to do your career. If you want to do your career into IT, you must start with the programming languages right now. If you want to do career in sales marketing, you just focus on your communication skills. If you want to do career with core industry, then you should have all core competencies. Like all, you should must know all design softwares. You must know all basic concepts of whichever fluid, thermal, SOM, whatever. So you must prepare for that, because if we look out of our college campus, you will get how much competition is there. Then and only you can get. So what my suggestion is that if you want to grab core opportunity, first of all, do internship into any core industry. First of all, right now apply for various core industry, find references over there, whatever, but first do internship over there. Then and then only you can get pre-placement opportunity. Like I was doing internship into Bajaj Finserv, and I got pre-placement opportunity over there. That company didn't visit our college even, so I got their placement externally. So like that you can do if you find your career into robotic sector. So this is very emerging sector right now, because you all aware about IoT, big data and machine learning, right? So if courses into this field, you can definitely get job, because there are less engineers who are into this field. Apart from robotics, there are two more fields, that is FEA and CFD. FEA means finite element analysis and CFD means computational fluid dynamics. So if you do courses of that, you will get definitely a job. And there are then two perspectives. Who want to do M.Tech? Okay, so for M.Tech, aapko job karni hai ya teaching field mein aana hai ya industry experience lena hai? Industrial. So let me clear. If you do best in gate exam, you will get industrial job definitely. Because what happens, if you get above 60 marks in gate, which is much more tougher to get, then you will get either PSC opportunity or IIT admission for M.Tech. So if you go into IIT or any reputed institute other than IIT, or if you get selected into PSU, then you will get the industrial exposure right away. But if you do M.Tech from any normal college, so then it will be very tough to get job into industry. Industry won't accept such people who are doing M.Tech from very normal colleges, frankly speaking. But if you want to do M.Tech, then make sure that you want to achieve the whatever you want, either growth in terms of money, otherwise steady life. If you talk about the teachers who have done M.Tech and PhD and they are teaching here, they have to have steady life. That's why they are here. Because if it comes to growth or package, the same age people, if you take, suppose take the example XYZ teacher, they have done 10 years of teaching here, and take the example of other batchmate from there who has done 10 years of experience in industry, there will be so much difference into that package. So actually it depends on person to person, that whether he wants growth or whether he wants steady life. So it's up to you what to choose. And if you take about the non-technical things, like if you want to do UPSC and MPSC, then right now it's time to start the study. Just go through basics of NCERT books like CBSC, and if you completed the these books, then you can join the classes, you know, that Unique Academy and Chanakya Mandal, like that. So if you want to pursue your career into government, then this is the time you should start. Because what happens, we all are engineers, we are from technical field, and the students who are appearing into that field are mostly from non-technical fields like arts, and so they have the touch of that particular subject like history, geography, economics, like that. So it will be easier for them to tackle us. So you have to start right now. And there is advantage for technical person into that field is that during the interview you can crack the interview very easily, as you have very good communication skills. That is the plus point for the engineers in of the field like UPSC, MPSC. If you talk about the MBA, then CAT ki preparation ka kaisa hai ki aapko jo placement ke liye aptitude ka studies rehta hai, same is for CAT. So if you are doing the study of aptitude for appearing for the companies, then you must CAT. Because if you clear the CAT with very good percentile, like 80-90, you will get very premium colleges, and you won't think that how much this package I am gaining. So that is the one more option of doing MBA, because industry wants the not only in industry seeks your technical skill, they seeks other than technical skills. Do you know what, I got selected into Kirloskar not just because of my technical, mostly it was because of my non-technical skill. Because it's in our hand, वो आपके हाथ में रहता है कि इंटरव्यू आपको कौन सा सवाल पूछेगा. आप खुद उसको डाइवर्ट कर सकते हो कि आपको क्या चाहिए कि इंटरव्यू मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछे, अपने हाथ में रहता है. सपोज इंटरव्यू ने मुझे बताया कि राहुल टेल मी अबाउट योरसेल्फ, मैंने सब बताया कि मेरा नाम ये है, आई बिलोंग्स टू दिस प्लेस, मैंने ये किया, लेकिन मैं प्रोजेक्ट तक नहीं गया. क्योंकि अगर मैं प्रोजेक्ट का बोलता, देन ही कुड हैव आस्क मी दी क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू कोर सब्जेक्ट्स, बट आई डिडंट वांट दैट. बिकॉज व्हाट हैपन, फ्रॉम लास्ट 3 years आई हैव बीन स्टडिंग फॉर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स, so I was not that much focused into technical field, but yet still my technical skills are very, very good. I'm technically sound, that's why I got so much pointer and all, and selected into core industries. But I was not so focused. So during interview mera confidence utna nahi tha ki mujhe technical questions kuch tricky pucha so I can give him answer. So what I decided during introduction, I completely diverted my intro into non technical field. So what happened, HR and technical both person ask me a non-technical questions totally, just like means मैंने उनको बताया मेरा स्पोर्ट्स के बारे में, मेरा सब इंटरेस्ट वगैरह, उसमें मैंने उनको कन्फ्यूज करके रख दिया. सो दे आस्क मी द सेम क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दैट फील्ड ओनली, आई डिडंट इवन टच टू माई प्रोजेक्ट टॉपिक. क्योंकि हर इंटरव्यू में क्या क्या होता है, कोर की, मैं कोर के इंटरव्यू की बात कर रहा हूँ, ऑफ दी कोर तो ये पूछते भी नहीं। कोर में क्या होता है कि सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट रहता है आपका प्रोजेक्ट, और प्रोजेक्ट के ऊपर से ही वो आपको जज करते हैं। मैंने प्रोजेक्ट को टच तक भी नहीं किया, मैं सब मतलब अदर देन टेक्निकल बातें बोल रहा था, बाकी सब मैंने बोल दिया। इवन माई प्रीवियस एक्सपीरियंस भी बताया, फिर वो बता रहे थे कि पूछ रहे थे कि हाउ यू परफॉर्म इन टू दैट कंपनी, हाउ यू टैकल दैट सिचुएशन, ब्ला ब्ला एटसेट्रा। सो इट्स अप टू यू कि इंटरव्यू आपको कौन सा क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहिए। सो इंटरव्यू की कोई ऐसी बात नहीं रहती बड़ी, अगर आपके पास कॉन्फिडेंस है देन यू कैन ईजिली टैकल दैट इंटरव्यू। एंड रही बात, लास्ट ऑप्शन इज एमएस, हु ऑल्स वांट टू डू एमएस? यस, सो डू यू वांट टू सेटल इन टू अदर कंट्री और जस्ट स्टडिंग देयर एंड कमिंग बैक टू इंडिया? बेटलस, ओके, सो यू मस्ट ऑप्ट फॉर जीआरई और आईएलटीएस, वॉट एवर। इफ इट कम्स टू मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर, देर इज मोर एक्सपोजर इन यूरोप रादर देन यूएस, बिकॉज यूएस इज वेरी वेल नोन फॉर सीएस एंड आईटी फील्ड। फॉर मैकेनिकल देर विल बी, यूरोप विल बी बेटर। सो एज आई एम पेट्रोटिक, आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परस्यू यूर हायर स्टडीज इन टू दैट कंट्री यू कैन गो, बट अप्लाई दिस नॉलेज फॉर अवर नेशन ओनली, बिकॉज इट्स अवर ड्यूटी दैट। कि मराठीमध्ये एक बोलतात की आपण ज्या समाजात जन्म घेतो त्या समाजाला काहीतरी देणं लागतो। सो इट्स अवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू गिव बॅक टू द अवर कंट्री, बिकॉज टिल नाव ड्यू टू दिस कंट्री वी हॅव बीन हियर, बिकॉज आय स्टडी इकॉनॉमिक्स, दॅट्स वाय आय नो व्हॉट अवर कंट्री डज फॉर अस। आपण सगळे म्हणजे आपण ब्लेम करतो की आपले रोड नाहीत नीट, हे नाहीत नीट, ते नीट नाही। आय अग्री विथ दॅट, दॅट इज अनदर इशू ऑफ गव्हर्नमेंट ऑर एनी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी, बट वेन एवर इट कम्स टू इकॉनॉमी विल यू फाइंड की अपना करंट स्टॅट्स है, इंडियाज जी डी पी इज 7.2%, विच इज हायर दॅन चायना अँड अमेरिका। सो इंडिया इज फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग कंट्री, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू एनी स्टार्टअप देन इंडिया इज द मार्केट बिकॉज ऑफ पॉप्युलेशन। सो जस्ट अभी थिंक कर लो कि बाहर सेटल होना है इंडिया में होना है। एज यू गाइज टोल्ड मी अबाउट ब्रीफ समथिंग अबाउट द इंटरव्यू, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ यू आर फेसिंग एन इंटरव्यू देर मे वन क्वेश्चन इज कंपल्सरी, दॅट इज टेल मी अबाउट युअर सेल्फ। डोंट स्टार्ट विथ माय सेल्फ, डोंट स्टार्ट विथ माय सेल्फ, जस्ट स्टार्ट विथ आय एम। इफ यू स्टार्ट विथ माय सेल्फ देन ग्रॅमॅटिकली इट इज इनकरेक्ट, सो थिंग्स टू बी रिमेंबर। स्टार्ट विथ युअर नेम, इफ दॅट एच आर ऑर टेक्निकल पर्सन इज सिटिंग इन अवर कॉलेज, डोंट टेल हिम, बिकॉज ही नोज दॅट ही इज सिटिंग इन टू अवर कॉलेज, ही हॅज विजिटेड अवर कॉलेज, सो दॅट मेक्स दी बॅड इम्प्रेशन। अँड आफ्टर दॅट डोंट स्टार्ट दॅट आय हॅव डन माय डिप्लोमा फ्रॉम दॅट युअर स्कूलिंग फ्रॉम दिस दिस दिस, बिकॉज ही हॅज सी वी इन टू हिज हँड, सो ही नोज दॅट यू हॅव डन युअर स्कूलिंग फ्रॉम दिस दिस स्कूल, यू हॅव गेट दॅट पर्सेंटेज। जस्ट सेड आय हॅव डन माय स्कूलिंग अँड डिप्लोमा अँड आय हॅव गॉट थ्रू आउट डिस्टिंक्शन लाईक दॅट। डोंट टेल हिम दॅट फ्रॉम विच कॉलेज ऑर फ्रॉम विच स्कूल यू हॅव स्टडीड, बिकॉज ही हॅज युअर रिझ्यूम इन टू हिज हँड, सो ही नो। सो आफ्टर दीज थिंग्स जस्ट टेल हिम आय वूड लाईक टू हायलाईट सम पॉईंट्स विच आर नॉट मेन्शन इन दॅट रिझ्युमे, सो दॅट मेक्स हिम टू फोकस ऑन यू ओनली रादर दॅन युअर सी वी, बिकॉज वॉट हॅपन्स, वॉट एवर यू हॅव रिटन इन टू युअर सी वी ही आस्क द क्वेश्चन बेस ऑन दॅट। इफ यू हॅव रिटन लाईक, टेक एक्झाम्पल ऑफ माइंड, आय हॅव रिटन माय हॉबीज एज ट्रॅव्हलिंग, स्विमिंग अँड करंट अफेअर्स, सो ही आस्क मी थ्री मेक्स द इम्प्रेशन इन ऑन टू इंटरव्ह्युअर। सो मेक शुअर दॅट बिफोर रायटिंग युअर रिझ्यूम राईट दोज थिंग्स विच यू आर अवेअर अबाउट इट, सो दॅट्स द मेन पॉईंट टू बी रिमेंबर, बिकॉज वॉट वी डू वी जस्ट कॉपी अँड पेस्ट द इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम अवर फ्रेंड्स रिझ्युमे, डोंट डू दॅट ॲट एनी कॉस्ट, बिकॉज रिझ्युमे इज अ युअर मिरर इमेज फॉर हिम, ही रिकग्नायझेस यू बेस्ड ऑन युअर रिझ्युमे। सो जस्ट मेक शुअर दॅट डोंट कॉपी एनी अदर्स रिझ्युमे अँड मेन्शन दोज थिंग्स ओनली विच यू आर नोन अबाउट इट, लाईक युअर हॉबीज ऑर प्रोजेक्ट्स अँड ऑल, बिकॉज वॉट हॅपन्स मोस्ट ऑफ द मेकॅनिकल इंजिनियर्स दे वॉट डू दे की दे मेन्शन दी प्रोजेक्ट्स विच दे डिंट हॅव, उन्होंने प्रोजेक्ट किया भी नहीं रहता फिर भी वो मेंशन करते हैं जस्ट फॉर सेक ऑफ गेटिंग जॉब, बिकॉज वो मतलब प्रोजेक्ट का ऐसा टाइटल डालते हैं कि इंटरव्यू वाले को लगेगा कि वाओ मतलब कुछ तो एकदम लेटेस्ट है लाइक रोबोटिक्स रिलेटेड, बट उसको कुछ नॉलेज भी नहीं रहता, सो इंटरव्यू को पता चलता है कि सब फेक इन्फॉर्मेशन है। सो योर रिज्यूमे शुड इंक्लूड दैट थिंग्स विच यू आर नोन। देन आफ्टर ड्यूरिंग द इंट्रोडक्शन द इट्स एज आई अर्लियर टोल्ड इट्स इन युअर हैंड टू डायवर्ट युअर इंटरव्यू, सो यू कैन स्टार्ट विथ युअर नॉन टेक्निकल थिंग्स फर्स्ट, like means whatever you have done, suppose sports, you are into sports, you have done any events, you have organized any events like these guys have organized this TRS like that, just focus on these things, because what industry sees other than technical, how much this guy can compete in real world, because in our India's population 1.42 billion all are not engineers, so to survive into this world we don't require only engineering knowledge, we require other than technical knowledge. like communication skills or behaving with society or doing anything for society. So that things matters most, because during my diploma interview I don't have that much to say. Like means into my engineering interview I had much more to say, like I have experience of Thermax or I have done that activities and all. But during my Thermax interview diploma period I didn't have that much to say, but still I managed to get, like I was into sports. So just focus on those things which you are comfortable with or which you are means all rounder into that things. So always focus on the non-technical things, like tell them like you have a social responsibility, because they see that every corporate has one sector CSR department, that is corporate social responsibility. And what does they, government has control over companies to do social things for the country. So they have this special department into their company of CSR, and under that department they do various social activities. So make sure that you please mention the your social activities,
mention the things
like tree plantation camp or blood donation camp. They don't going to ask you more about that, just mention that. You can mention sports also, second thing, whether you have played or not, you just mention. But if you really genuinely played the state or national, then only mention I'm national player or state player, because they may ask about the certificate, that show me your certificate about national. If you think tell them like you are a sports player, then it's fine. But if you are going to tell them that I'm national or state player, then it going to hamper your interview, because they may ask, because interview has asked me show me your certificate, because I told that I was captain of Maharashtra and I have played national and all. So he asked me to show the certificate. So don't tell things very bigger. If you are not into that field, then just keep it simple. But you should mention you are sports player and you are pretty comfortable with social responsibilities. That makes the difference into your interview other than others. Because what people do, other candidates I have seen, because I have given almost 7 to 8 core companies interview and I got selected into each of them, just because I am telling my experience, that what everybody does, they mention their technical skills to them. They knew that they are hiring for a technical position, they knew that each one is technically competent to each other, but they want something which is not into everybody. So they are seeking that thing which is not into everybody, which is what, that is you must be sports player, second one you must be socially responsible. So that is the thing. And after that there comes the extracurricular activities like camping and all like that. So that is the thing. And also please do mention that I have done communication skills training program organized by that XYZ. That also makes difference, that this guy has the proper knowledge of the corporate communication. So these are the things which you have to mention into your introduction. And whenever at the last of the introduction they ask about your projects. So what I don't know means you guys are going to do your BE project in which field, like I'm doing into mechatronics, that is related to almost robotics. So I'm pretty much comfortable with mechatronics, that's why I'm doing that project. So just make sure that which project you are going to do, and you should have thoroughly knowledge of that project and also that related subject. If you are doing your project into heat transfer or like that, you should have whole thoroughly knowledge, like right from zeroth law of thermodynamics to thermodynamics third law. So these are the things which you have to keep into the mind during interview. And interview may ask the your which is your favorite subject, then you decide which one to choose. Like interviewer asked me which is your favorite subject, I told him mechatronics, because I knew that interviewer was old age people. Mechanical and old age, like 20 years 25 years of experience, and I was pretty confirmed that ki usko mechatronics ka itna kuch malum nahi hoga, just basic malum hoga. So maine wahi bola ki mechatronics is my favorite subject. So usne bas basic pucha ki ye kya rehta hai, wo kya rehta hai, control loop and all like that, PLC SCADA wagera etc kya rehta hai, baki kuch bhi nahi pucha. So isliye main bola ki it's in our hand to ki interview aapko kidhar divert karna hai. अगर वो एकदम मतलब नया नया बंदा होगा आगे वाला, देन ही विल बी हैविंग दैट नॉलेज, दैट टाइम यू कैन से सॉम टॉम थर्मल एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. द बेस्ट वे टू टैकल दैट कोर सब्जेक्ट इट इज सॉम, बिकॉज देयर इज मच मोर आस्क इन टू थर्मल फील्ड और फ्लूइड फील्ड. वो एक ऐसा फील्ड है कि उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं, बट सॉम इज द सब्जेक्ट विच आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस इन L&T इंटरव्यू. इंटरव्यू कैन आस्क यू लेस क्वेश्चन इन टू सॉम, because they just ask that you are sitting on a chair, just draw your SCOE VMD diagram, just we universal distributed load hai, simply supported hai, and you have to draw SCOE VMD whichever. So SOM mein kaisa hai, ek straight forward hai, there is no calculations and all, convergence calculations hai, but there is no much more convergence and all like thermal field or whatever. There are no constants like CP CV like that. So this is the one more way to tackle the technical interview. If they ask about you, your favorite subject, you can either go for mechatronics or SOM or whatever, triple E may be there. And also if you prove your proficiency other than core subjects, like if you tell him mechatronics is my favorite or triple E is my favorite, then he will be having interest during interviewing you, because he knows that everybody has the core subjects knowledge, but this guy has the knowledge of core plus non-core. Non-core means of the field, like electronics field ho ya mechatronics field ho. So wo bhi ek impression hota hai interview mein. So ye cheeze hai ki jo aapko yaad rakhni hai. Aur baki kuch nahi, aapko kuch question aata, answer aata bhi nahi, matlab jhoota answer de do, but be confident about that. Unka wahi rehta hai ki if I hire this guy and this guy is going to convince the client in future or for my company's business, then if businessman ask any tricky question to him, can he be confident to give answers if even it is not true answer? So that makes sense. So yahi hai ki if you are giving to wrong answer, give it but confidently. So this one is a trick during the interview. And so that's it. Baki sab matlab khud ko ek apni competency level malum rehti hai ki up to which peak I can reach. So it's up to how to handle your interview. So this is what I have experienced, 6-7 companies in core companies interview. So this was all from my side. And as he asked me about the UPSC, so if any engineer is doing UPSC, no need to do separate study of aptitude, because we all engineers, we are much more matlab calculus than other non-technical guys. So you just focus on general study. There are two papers for UPSC pre-exam, GS1, and second one paper is aptitude paper. So aptitude has only passing marks, that is out of 200 you have to get 66 marks. So you can easily achieve that 66 marks if you are engineer. So you just have to focus on the GS paper, general studies, which includes your history, geography, economics, science, etc., and environment. So you just have to focus on that. If you are going to prepare for the competitive, you must start right now, because there is huge competition into that field. But thing is that if you want any reputation, then you must go with government exam. If you want your personal growth, you must go with private sector. So there is dilemma about that public sector and private sector. If you ask me whether you want to pursue a career, I will tell you that I want to pursue my career in public or government, whatever. वो खुद का इंटरेस्ट रहता है. कोई लोगों को लगता है कि नहीं मुझे प्राइवेट में जॉब करना है, ऐसा 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 करना है, इट्स दैट्स अप टू यू. एंड फाइनल पॉइंट दैट इज आता है कि वही स्टार्टअप का. तो स्टार्टअप का वही बताया मैंने कि यू जस्ट पुट योर आइडिया इन टू IIT इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर, दे विल रीच टू यू विथ सोल्यूशन एंड असिस्टेंस, बट यू जस्ट हैव प्रॉपर डेटा टू रिप्रेजेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम, बिकॉज मेनी मोर स्टूडेंट्स गो टू द IIT एंड प्रेजेंट देयर डेटा इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम, बट दे डोंट came back with proper solution because what? Lack of data. So please do ensure that you have proper data, also plus point. So वही रहता है कि interview कैसे tackle करना है, but interview के लिए पहुँचने के लिए आपको ये सब चीज़ें करनी पड़ेगी. जैसे कि ईश्वर का membership ले लो, तो ईश्वर का membership लेने के बाद आपको last year में you will get chance to appear for the ईश्वर exam. Second thing is you take membership of CoQIPS and MCAT. TPC will tell you that when to take the membership. Actually what if we current scenario in India is that ki ab kaisa hai, there are few core companies, like suppose in 100 core companies in India which are premier core companies, but there are lakhs of mechanical engineering students who are going to pass out this year. So these companies are few and students are more, so then don't get the ideal students to recruit. So what they do, they are using the platform of CoQIPS and MCAT. So based on that CoQIPS and MCAT, they call candidates directly for the interview. I got 10 to 12 calls from MCAT for interview. I didn't went that apart. So this is the one means technique to get job into core company, but just make sure you have pretty much good score into that exam too, because CoQIPS has opted by many students, but many students hasn't got any single call yet. So this is the thing to keep into your mind. So but MCAT is also best platform rather than CoQIPS. I will assist you that, because from my personal experience I got 3 calls from CoQIPS and 10 to 12 calls from MCAT, from companies for appearing for the interview. So this is the thing where you can utilize your knowledge. And after that wahi hua, fir college mein jo bhi company aayegi har ek ko appear karte jao. And kaisa hua ki abhi take example of MBA. MBA, does anybody knows about latest MBA result? CAT exam result. There were 11 students who got 100 percentile in India, and all 11 students are engineer. Means we are thinking na ki arre main to engineering hu, main MTech lunga, MBA kyun lunga. So if you look into the result, then all 1100 percentiles are engineers and 7 are from Maharashtra only. So what things are changing? I have listened one video, I'm not getting that name. So as I'm interested in economics, that's why I have listened that video. So what was there in that video? There are four industry revolutions in India right after our independence. First revolution took place in 1980s, that was into core companies. What happened? Core companies, jo Tata ho apne, Bajaj ho, they set up their companies into 1980s, 1970s. So mechanical and civil engineers got major opportunities to do job into core industries. Means easily, koi bhi mechanical engineer ho, without interview recruit karte the. Ek situation thi 1980s mein. Because that time market grow ho raha tha and they wanted many engineers, as many engineers, particularly mechanical engineers, because core sector was emerging sector in 1980s. What after in 1990s emergency ke baad kya hua? 1990s mein PV Narasimha Rao was prime minister and India ki ab aisi economical situation aayi thi ki na aaya tha ki India ke bas 7 din ka paisa bacha tha Indian government ke paas to run our country. So India was into very economical crisis. So that time Manmohan Singh was our finance minister. So what he does, he accepts the policy of LPG, liberalization, privatization and globalization. And from that point India is now growing up. So what happens in globalization, many foreign companies invested into our country. And that foreign companies was mostly IT companies. So like Google, Microsoft, like that company. And also our Infosys, Wipro companies will also emerges out. Because globalization ka meaning is that अपन भी बाहर जाके कर सकते हैं बिजनेस और बाहर के लोगों को भी अपनी इधर बिजनेस करने दे सकते हैं, लाइक दैट पॉलिसी थी वो. सो अपने भी आईटी सेक्टर बढ़ गया, उनका भी बढ़ गया. सो मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर का पहला रिवॉल्यूशन था 1980s का, जब कोर में जॉब्स मिलते थे. अपने 1990s का हुआ कि वी मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर्स गॉट अपॉर्चुनिटी फ्रॉम आईटी कंपनीज. सो आफ्टर दैट 2000 के बाद देयर वॉज न्यू ट्रेंड लाइक आईटी इनेबल्ड सर्विसेज. सो ऑल दिस टीसीएस, इन्फोसिस, विप्रो, ऑल आर आईटी इनेबल्ड सर्विसेज कंपनीज. दे आर नॉट आईटी प्रोडक्ट कंपनीज, they are IT enabled services companies. So mechanical engineer got opportunity into that field also. And from last 3 to 4 years, trend has been changed. There is a much more market for sales and marketing. If you ask me the which company has given highest package in Pune, not in our campus, in Pune, then it is a sales and marketing company, that is Jarvo Education. So thing is that if you don't adjust yourself with the current scenario, then aapko pashtana padega baad mein. So just don't stuck to your core. Means our teacher will tell you that ki engineering kiya hai, mechanical kiya hai, so you just restrict to mechanical field. But things are not like that. Wo sab revolutions aate gaye. Abhi ek naya revolution hai, wo hai ki sales and marketing ka. And why they are hiring engineers? Because if 100 bande, 100 students are doing MBA, out of 100, 70 students are engineering background. So they know they are hiring engineers after MBA. Why they can't hire engineers on BE basis, BE or BTEC basis? That's why these sales and marketing companies are going to visit various engineering colleges. So this is the thing you should keep into mind, that it is sales or marketing company, I should not appear for that. Don't think like that. If you are genuinely interested, you opt for it, you can make career with it. If you want only money, then sales and marketing is the only option. Aap kabhi bhi jao, matlab, I have seen various companies' culture, I have worked on, so I know that. कोर की ग्रोथ कैसे रहती है? सपोज आई एम वर्किंग इन टू कंपनी लाइक थर्मैक्स और एनी बिगर जायंट, टाटा, बजाज, आई विल गेट ओनली 10 to 12% मैक्सिमम पर एनम ग्रोथ. मीन्स सपोज दिस ईयर मेरी सैलरी 25,000 है, अगले साल मेरी सैलरी 3,000 बढ़ेगी, 12%, मतलब 28,000 होगी. सो आई गेट ओनली 10 to 12% ऑफ हाइक. बट इफ यू गो टू सेल्स एंड मार्केटिंग, यू विल बी पेड ऑन यूर परफॉर्मेंस बेसिस. ऐसा है, इफ यू आर ग्रैबिंग द बिजनेस फॉर दैट फर्म, यू विल गेट बेनिफिट्स टू, एंड देयर hike will be around 20-30%. So if you are thinking about the your personal growth and money, wealth, then you must go with the non-technical field, I will suggest. So thing is that ki apna matlab aisa ghodi ke jaisa mat rakho ki ek hi engineering kar rahe to I want to pursue my job into engineering only. Don't think like that. Kyunki explore, khud ko explore karo to various fields. Agar ek hi track pe chalte rahenge to ek hi matlab growth bhi utni rahegi. If you are having various domain knowledge, then you can reach that peak. बाकी वही अभी ये आपने जो चालू किया है वो, that's very amazing one. TRS, I hope you will be doing better into this. Thank you.